I can customize how I view the information on my data logger with the CR1000KD by creating a custom menu in the data logger program. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to do that. A custom menu is created in the data logger program with the CRBasic editor. When I select the custom menu category in this drop-down list of data logger instructions, I see 7 instructions that relate to custom menus. 4 of these instructions are used to set up the structure of the menu. The other 3 are used to specify the information to display. With the cursor somewhere between my data table and the beginning of the program, I select Display Menu End Menu to begin creating my custom menu. This dialog window shows the 3 parameters for the data menu instruction. In the first parameter, I specify the name of my custom menu. I will call this one User Menu. The second parameter is called Add to System. It controls how and where the menu will be displayed. When I leave the Add to System parameter at its default of 0, my custom menu will be listed with the other system menus. If I change it to -1, the custom menu becomes the main menu and the default menus are moved to a menu called System Menu. Changing it to -2 does the same thing, but the custom menu displays after a few seconds without pressing any key on the keypad. If I don't want the other menus to appear at all, I use option -3 as the Add to System parameter. If I only want to see the custom menu and the menu that lets me change settings on the display, I'll use option -4. To avoid confusion in this demonstration, I will use option -3 so the custom menu is the only one displayed. The third parameter in the display menu instruction, called cursor, lets me select which line number the cursor will be on when I enter the menu. I can enter a number from 1 to 7 here. I will leave this at the default of 0. With my parameter set, I select Insert. I could enter information to display between the instructions Display Menu and End Menu. But to keep my display clean, I will include smaller menus called submenus by selecting the instructions Submenu and Submenu. There are 2 parameters in the Submenu dialog window. This is where I specify a name for the submenu and the default line number for the cursor. I want a menu that displays information about the data logger power supply, so I will call this submenu Power Supply. I will leave the cursor parameter at default and select Insert. Now I'm ready to define the information that will be found in the Power Supply submenu. At the top, I want to see the latest battery voltage measurement, so I select Menu Item to open this window. There are 2 parameters in the Menu Item dialog window. This is where to specify the name shown on the display and the associated measurement value for that name. I will name this item Battery. Right-click on the Menu Variable field to see a list of declared variables. Select Bat Volt and then Insert. If I want to display data from a table other than the public table, I use the instruction called Display Value. The first parameter in Display Value is the name to show on the display. I want to display the minimum battery voltage, so I name this value Min Voltage. The second parameter, called Menu Expression, is where to specify the table name and field name to display. The minimum battery voltage is stored in the data table called Test with a field name BatVoltMin, so I type that here. See the CRBasic help for TableName.FieldName for details about the syntax to use the Menu Expression parameter. Now I'm ready to insert display value into my program. If I want to display custom text in my menu, I select the instruction called DisplayLine. The only parameter for DisplayLine is a field to enter what is to be displayed on that line. Put text within quotation marks and use the ampersand to attach variables and field names. For this line, I want to show the number of times my data logger has shut down because the battery dropped too low. This information is found in the status table under the field name low12vcount. Try to keep the information in the display line to 20 characters or less, so there's no need to use the right arrow to see the full message. For my display line value, I type the text low power errors with a colon and a space in quotation marks, followed by the ampersand and the table name status, period, field name, low12vcount, followed by 1, 1 in parentheses. Now I select Insert. I can create a list of selectable options that can be used when editing a menu item value. This is done with the menu pick instruction. Here is an example. In this program, I have a constant table that contains a constant called scan rate that is set to 1 by default. That constant is used here in the scan instruction to tell my data logger the rate in seconds at which to execute the program. I want to be able to change the scan rate with CR1000KD. The data table, test, has a data interval of 15 seconds. I need to ensure that the scan rate choices are evenly divisible into 15 seconds. I will choose scan rate options of 1 second, 5 seconds, and 15 seconds. I'll start by adding a new submenu called Configuration. Next, I'll add a menu item called scan rate and specify the constant table scan rate in the menu variable field. Next, I select menu pick. In this case, I want my list of options to apply to a constant in a constant table. So I must first list the name of the constant, then a comma, then the list of options separated by commas. A change to a constant isn't applied until the data logger program is recompiled. I will add a menu item that allows me to use the keypad to manually force the data logger to recompile the program. For that, I select the menu recompile instruction. The first parameter of menu recompile is a string of text that asks me whether I want to force a recompile. The second parameter is the name of a Boolean variable that will be used to tell the data logger whether to recompile. In this example, I have declared a Boolean value called recompile to use here. So I right-click on the field for the compileVar parameter and, from the list of declared variables, select recompile. Then I select insert. My custom menu is now complete. I will compile the program and send it to my data logger. With the program running, I can see my custom menu called user menu and the two submenus, power supply and configuration. When I select power supply, I can quickly see the three lines of information about the power supply that are most important to me. I back up a level by pressing Escape and select the submenu called Configuration. I select Scan Rate and now see the options available to me. I navigate to one of those options and select. Now I select the recompile item and change it from false to true to manually force my program to recompile and use the new value for scan rate. For more information on custom menus, see the CRBasic help for the instructions covered in this video.